Welcome to the third graduation ceremony of International University of East Africa. What you're witnessing right now, it's the first step of every graduation and it's called the procession. This procession is being spearheaded by the Chancellor of this university called Honorable Tumusiime Mtebile, the Governor Bank of Uganda. And after this procession, we're going to head into the auditorium and the graduation will officially begin. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, my name is Casmir. Welcome to Campus 101. Enjoy the graduation.
Staring yesterday, I was watching you, were walking, I was lost for what to say. I was hoping, girl, I'm asking, will you stay?
For starters, they were brought up to speak very different. Say, in the morning, they woke up to say, Oliotia. And maybe some of them woke up in the morning to say, Habari. A couple of them did wake up in the morning to say, Salam Taki. All different people, not only speaking different languages, but also eating different foods. Some of them woke up in the morning one more time to eat some matoke. Some of them had some ravishing and very tasty sukumawiki in their afternoon, and a number of them went to sleep very satisfied with enjoy.
Girl, everybody make me to party, oh. Say you got the magic touch, perfect. And if you're ready, girl, I'm ready.
Our highly international body of students from over 30 countries, our president of the Students Guild, the distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, you are very, very welcome to the third graduation ceremony of IUEA.
You are welcome to this year's IUEA graduation ceremony. We are pleased and honored to celebrate this momentous occasion with you all.
This is an institution which believes in education for a purpose. We are less than 10 years old. We have not yet achieved our decade celebration as a university. But even in our infancy, we have been given both national and international acclaim.
I was blessed as a young boy to have a good relationship with my grandparents. My grandmother on my mother's side of the family was a big influence in my life. She would encourage me to take time and slowly think about what I wanted to say and then say it. She would always tell me that no matter what I wanted out of life, it was possible because I am a gift to this world. That concept has been with me for most of my life and has proven to be a fact.
Mr. Chancellor, sir, I have the honor to present to you the following candidates who have satisfied the Board of Examiners of the Faculty of Business and Management and the Senate for the award of the degree of Masters of Business Administration of International University of East Africa. Hope Kuku Wamkota, Namara Eunice, Nilesh Ryan, Pamela Osia Elubu, Senfuka Ivan.
By virtue of the authority entrusted to me, I confer upon all those candidates who have been presented the degree of Masters of Business Administration of the International University of East Africa.
Everything where you do make my things stand on. Oh God, say my girl like to dance while I sing my song.
I have the honor to present to you the following candidates who have satisfied the Board of Examiners of the Faculty of Business and Management and the Senate for the award of the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration of the International University of East Africa.
Arol Pitago Arol, Ayu Arop Ring Deng, Baguma Chirimami Enoch, Deng Banabalonga, Ding Dabra Kunye, Dirajal Zulaika.
By virtue of the authority entrusted to me, I confer upon all those candidates who have been presented the degree of Bachelor of Information Technology of International University of East Africa.
The celebrations won't cease because it's a very big day for so many young people like this one. What's your name?
So I'm called Gael Mwenge Mastaki.
Okay, which course have you been doing?
I've been doing information technology.
Information technology. That is 3 years, right?
Yes, this is 3 years now.
Finally, we have a topic we're discussing today on the show. Do you think we still need history on the education syllabus?
So all about the education, we know that education is most of the greatest thing that can help us to go ahead in our life. And what we know, without education, we can't do anything. So educated people are the one who are going to build this world and are the one who are going to bring some beneficial things that we all going to benefit in.
Did you study history back in the day?
I did history, but...
Did you think it was necessary?
In history, they always tell us that we always look back at what was in history so that we may prepare so that we may live perfectly the present and prepare our future.
What's your good name?
Nancy Benjamin.
Benjamin, which course have you been doing?
Business administration.
Business administration.
Yeah.
Okay, now, do you already have a job yet or you're still going to be looking out for one?
Not yet. I'm still looking for it.
Yeah, okay. Mm. But you don't seem excited. I want to see the energy.
I'm excited. Yeah.
Now, did you study history back in the day?
Yeah, long time back.
Yes. Now, my question is, do you think we still need history on the education syllabus or should it be scrapped off?
We should have it.
All right, I just met the Guild President of International University of East Africa. How are you doing, my man?
I'm just doing great.
People can't see you very well because of...
I'm just doing very great.
So tell me about this entire graduation. How do you find the experience?
It's the best graduation I've ever seen.
Sure.
This is the happiest time when people have to share their happiness around the university. For all the graduates who have gone through, I feel happy for them.
Okay, now, Mr. President, before I let you go, we have a topic. Did you study history back in the day?
Oh, yes, I did.
Do you think we still need history on the education syllabus of Uganda?
We don't need it.
Why?
Because these days the world is going technological. It's going developed. History is just a set of, it's supposed to stop somewhere like in S2, S1, because it's supposed to open up minds of the students to know that there was the future. There's always the past to drive the future.
Yeah, but you don't support history in the higher level of education?
I don't support it.
Okay, thank you so much, Mr. President, and have yourself a good day. What's your good name?
Anyang Akolgak.
Oh, Nyango, which course have you been doing?
Petroleum Engineering.
Wow, that's a very big course, I should say. What plans do you have for yourself after here now?
Yeah, obviously it's going to look for a job back in my country and try to transform it from the skills that I found from this great university.
Okay, amazing, amazing. Did you study history back in the day?
Some little bit in primary, but I never took it in high school.
Now, the question is, do you think the syllabus of education still needs subjects like history?
Actually, yes, to some extent, because we need to learn the background of what happened, the failures of the previous leaders and the success of the previous leaders, so that we can determine of what we aim and what we need in future. So I think it's required,
though.
Do you support
the government to have history on our syllabus?
Surely I support it.
Okay, so are you guys family or you just friends? I need to know.
Yeah, we are family. She's my sister. I don't know. I don't want sometimes my media know my family, but she's my brother also.
Your brother.
Yeah,
she's my brother. And how come you're not graduating? Are you the eldest or the youngest?
I understand that question will come from many of people, but you know we have some problems about.
Yeah, I know.
We have to finalize, you know, school.
A theory text, you know. But
no,
don't worry about that.
But anyway,
now, yeah.
I
have a topic for you guys. Eh? Did you study history from where you come from?
History, yes. Yeah.
You think we still need to study subjects like history?
Yeah, history is very important, yes.
Why?
Yeah, because we need to learn what was in the past, what was before, because history is something which continues every day. It's a continuation. Actually, history doesn't stop. It's there every day.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we have come at the end of the third graduation ceremony of International University of East Africa. It had so much incredible fun today. And well, most of the students, all the graduates, are agreeing that we should remain with studying history because it's very important to know what went down back in the days. Otherwise, see you in the second part of the show. I remain Casmir, the Campus King Africa. God bless you.